How are you doing, guys? We had a very interesting day here at the factory facility today, together with about 60 guests here in Thailand who came to see the facility and learn more about Corsair as a company, about the CSR plastic credit, and generally everything that we do about the plastic waste recycling here at the Corsair's Bangkok facility. Now, let me take you guys on a small, short virtual tour where we're gonna show you the process and the generally about the facility of how everything works over here. Let's go on a tour, guys. Thank you. All right, guys, what you see behind me are the two new production units that were imported and delivered here at the production facility a couple of months ago. What we are doing right now is we are preparing the site here on my right-hand side where we are doing the needed ground support piling work so that we can install these two machines onto that warehouse. That installation will bring our overall production capacity significantly up from the current situation and help us to produce more oil and, most importantly, to remove more plastic waste from the environment each month. Our existing processing facility contains altogether about 10,000 square meters of space. If you look to my right, you can see our property line beginning about 15 meters after the end of the building, and then going all the way back to my left, all the way where you can see the last tip of the roof of the facility. This area here contains altogether approximately 10,000 square meters. We have also secured an additional 10,000 square meters of space, which is there on the right-hand side of me. There we have, on the other side of the road, a space where we are going to be building a full-scale plastic waste raw material processing facility for all the pre-treatment of the plastic before it gets entered into the machine. So what you can see behind me is the so-called Bangkok 2 extension area for the Bangkok facility. So now, please follow me and let's go check out the Bangkok 1 area. This way, guys. Also, what you can see behind me are the mountains of plastic. Those mountains are all plastic waste which has been recently covered by more plastic. Some of this plastic here behind me is more than 30 years old, just waiting for someone to come and take care of it. This way, guys. Now, let me walk you guys through the process. The process here at the facility always begins with the plastic waste. As you can see here, this is the type of raw material that we use on our day-to-day operations. This plastic has been collected from the local communities from where we have separated the plastic from the general domestic garbage. This plastic, as you can see, has not been in any specific way treated. It's just been separated from the general domestic waste. After that, it's been dried and packed into these bales, where each bale weighs approximately 60 to 70 kilos. What happens for this plastic once it's brought here to the facility is that we would initially first measure all the plastic here at the weighing station, and then from here it gets entered into the machines. Now, the history of this facility begins in August 2020 when Corsair purchased this facility from the previous owner, who had already been operating this facility for the last few years. Unfortunately, the facility was in a very bad condition and very poorly managed, but it was operational and already at the time of acquisition had 1, 2 existing chemical recycling production machines. What we have done since August 2020 is we have been fixing the facility, developing it, improving its conditions, adding more technology, more machines, more equipment, including the third machine on my left, and overall bringing the facility more towards international standards in operation. On my right-hand side, we also have a small-scale oil distillation machine, which is used to produce diesel and gasoline from the oil that we manufacture. That is also something that we are looking to be working with later in the future. Now, let me walk you through the process while we move next to the machine, which is currently operational. Please follow me, guys. All right, guys. So what happens here is the following. The plastic waste is injected into the machine, into the cylinder, into the reactor, from the hatch at the end of the machine. Once the plastic is inside, the hatch is closed, and after that, the process can begin. In average, we would place between 5,000 to 6,000 kilos of plastic waste at one time inside the reactor before we initiate the process. What we do is we start to apply heat into the plastic. Very important is to highlight that we never burn the plastic itself. There is no flames ever touching the actual plastic. What happens when we heat the plastic is that the plastic will begin to emit two types of elements. There are gases which we would capture, and we would channel these gases back into the furnace through the red color pipeline behind me. Therefore, we can use these gases in the actual process to heat up the machine itself. The other element that we receive from the process is the smoke. What we do with the smoke is we channel the smoke through our distillation system, where the smoke is now being converted back into the liquid form, which is the advanced bio oil. Now, this oil can then be used to make traffic fuels such as diesel and gasoline, but also can be used as a raw material for the manufacturing of new plastic products. And that is exactly what we are focusing here at Corsair. Some of that oil will then be used to also operate the next cycle of plastic recycling. And therefore, the machine itself operates on its own gas and oil. It really is a very efficient, very effective method of recycling the plastic waste. We do use some electricity, primarily to run some of the electric engines of the machine. For example, the ones that are turning the cylinder. But we are also now implementing new steps where we are going to begin to using solar power, and by doing so, having the facility complete energy sufficient and out of grid. Thank you very much, guys, for joining us here today. We appreciate your support, and we are very thankful for sharing this amazing journey with you guys. Thank you, and see you soon. Bye.